There's a beautiful story. Einstein's driver. That guy was working for Einstein for 10 years. Einstein, after coming out with his theory of relativity, continuously day in and day out, going to so many thousands of places and speaking about this theory of relativity, day in and day out, continuously, Einstein was delivering lectures on theory of relativity. Now, by now, this guy also has learned the whole thing, the driver also. One day, they were going for a lecture. Einstein said, you see, I am feeling totally bored, again and again speaking the same thing. I don't know what to do. I'm just terribly sick. The driver says, sir, don't worry. Now, after listening so many times, I can deliver the whole discourse. And after all, these people don't know who is Einstein. They have not seen your photograph. Let me go and give the discourse. Don't worry. Einstein said, that's a wonderful idea. That's nice. Great. He gave the quote and sent him to the stage. And he gave the complete discourse. Really, he did a good job. Fantastic job. After the discourse, suddenly one person got up and raised a question. Now comes all the difficulty. Then that guy says, such a simple question, my driver can answer to this. For this question, why are you coming to me? Go to my driver, hey, come up and answer. Then Einstein comes to the stage and answers the whole questions. So you can act as a master as long as you have to give only discourse. But in best man comes to the question answer, what will happen? Your face will be known. People will discover the truth. For question answer, you need to have spontaneity, and what you are speaking should become your blood, your being. To give a discourse is very easy. It's not a big deal. Just memorize 6 days total transformation. Go there and start taking class. Oh, one day in the tribal area, there was aircraft, and tribal people have started using it as a bullock cart. You can start repeating the whole story. That's not a big deal. But when people ask, what is chakra? Chakra, 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 that rotates, man. This side and this side. You see, I'll tell you in the end of the session. Then comes the whole thing. Whether you are a teacher or master, the whole thing will come out. If you see, a person shining in question answer, you can be sure he's a spontaneous person. At least in our programs, you will see question answers will be much more sharp, straight away touching than discourse. Because the whole thing is from spontaneity. Whole thing is from spontaneity. Unless you have that spontaneity, unless in your system the thinking, editing and delivering, all the three has disappeared into one, you cannot be spontaneous. You cannot be spontaneous. Somebody asked me, after seeing our intuitive management DVD, one of our discourse in Microsoft, one person asked me, Swami, where did you learn the professional orating skill? Where did you learn? I said, learning? I only teach. I never learned. And he said that whatever a professional orator will do, you're doing the whole thing. How is it possible? I told him that I don't know. This is the way it happens. It's a pure confidence and the spontaneity that takes the whole role. You see, ability to be spontaneous is what is responsibility. When I sit in the chair and start speaking about some subject, I take the responsibility of making you understand that subject. Making you understand that subject, that's all. Let me give you the definition of orating, a simple one-liner. Creating a words through which you will create the same visualization which is there in your head, in others' person is orating. Understand? Reproducing the same visualization which is in your head through words in others' head is orating. reproducing the same experience which is in your being, in others being, through meditation is the work of Guru. Reproducing the same visualization which is in your head, in others head, through words is communication. Reproducing the same experience which is in your being, in others being, through your presence is communion. That's all. When a person becomes a master, thinking, words and body language, all these three disappears into him, into one. He doesn't have all these three. One more thing. You need separately thinking and speaking if you are cunning. If you want to achieve something through that words. If you just want to pamper somebody and have something, then what you have to do? Even though in the mind you think you are an idiot and fool, you have to say, oh, I have not seen such an intelligent person like you. You are so great. You are this, you are that. When you don't have any vested interest, you can straight away truthful. There is no need for editing. There is no need for censor board. No censor board is necessary. Straight away what comes, comes. Over. You don't have to bother. Yes. One thing, just be mature. You see, now just be matured and be matured, the very thinking system should be altered. Not the speaking system, very thinking system should be altered. That's nice, for some time go in a roller coaster. You will not be continuously able to go in a roller coaster. After a few minutes you will settle down. You have to get down from roller coaster. You are continuously in roller coaster because you are not cooperating with roller coaster. The moment you cooperate with roller coaster, you will feel such a deep relaxation, such a deep centeredness, you will be just totally relaxed. One thing, you don't have to resist the roller coaster, ma. Just go with the roller coaster. And if you go with the roller coaster, after a few minutes, you will be naturally allowed to get down. Otherwise also you will be thrown out, because next batch has to sit. Next batch has to get in. There is no need to throw, ma. Just live with it. Over. Enjoy it. You don't even have to throw. Just enjoy. Go with the roller coaster. You don't have to throw. Just relax. You will see roller coaster itself drops you. And if you see this river, it will be beautiful. All these stones will be brought by the rivers and they will just hit each other and rush like anything towards the plains. After some time, slowly, by grinding, just getting continuously ground, the stones, once they will become like a shivalinga, a complete shivalinga, they will be thrown out of the river. They will come and fall in the banks of the river. People will take that and start worshipping. Same way, if you also allow the life to work on you, it will just nicely grind you. It will grind you. Once you become Shiva, completely polished, totally shine, ground, you will be thrown out of the life river. You will become enlightened. People will start worshipping you. That's all. The stone, raw stone, nicely ground, once it becomes Shivalinga, it is thrown out of the river. And you pick up that and start worshipping it. Same way, allow the life to penetrate you. Allow the life to work on you. It will nicely ground you. It will completely mold you, shape you. The moment you become all right, you will be thrown out. Automatically you will be thrown out. Till completely the grinding process is done, you will not be thrown out. Only when the grinding process is complete, you will be thrown out. Then You are out of the samsara sagara. You are enlightened, liberated. You will be worshipped by people as a Shiva. Allow the life to work on you. Allow the life to penetrate you. Allow the life to mold you. What is there? So now, let us come back to this question. How can I distinguish between master's words and thinking body language? First thing, you can't distinguish because there is no three thing in master. His word, thinking and body language is one and the same. So don't bother to distinguish. Just listen his words. Whatever effect it creates on you according to your Oxford dictionary is enough. Don't refer something more. What you understand is enough. Just allow that process to happen. If the river has to come like this, both the side, if a wall is big, wall is built, naturally the river will flow only in that way. So if I want that person's action should be in a particular course, I'll bang him in other direction, insert in the engram. Naturally, will flow only in that direction in which I wanted. So just what you understand, work with it. Stand up and work with it. That's enough. Else will be taken care. So you can neither distinguish nor understand the difference between master's words and thinking and body language, because there is no three things exist in him. If you try to distinguish, you are already in trouble. You are already in trouble. As early as possible, get out of that trouble. If you enjoy, just be in that trouble and enjoy it. Yes.
After reaching you, then we have a due path in the process. Is it from you?
New thought. One thing, whenever it is from intuition, from master, you will have the energy also to execute that thought. Then be very clear, it is a boon from me. If you have only the thought and confusion, how to do it? Be very clear, it is not the thought from me. If you have the energy also to execute, it is from me. With instinct, you will neither have thought nor have energy. Just it will go. With intellect, you will have thought but not energy. With intuition, you will have thought and energy, both. Instinct, you will neither have thought nor energy. Animals. With intellect, you will have thought but not energy. Confusion. With intuition, you will have thought and energy, both. If you have both, it's straight from master, straight from Anandaganda, A.G.